All right, we're now on the air. We're reaching the whole world if we're listening. We want to make everybody out in the internet world and Facebook welcome to hear our program this morning. We trust that we'll be a blessing to you and a help to you. At this time, our brother Don is going to come and sing one of them good gospel songs. I love good gospel singing. So it's going to go forth in the power and the demonstration of the Spirit of God. Come on, Brother Don.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor, for that.
If I leave this world of sorrow sometime before you do, just look for me in heaven and we'll talk. Oh,
ahead and switch it, Rosie, please.
Thank God.
Praise God.
All right. Praise the Lord. Once again, I want to dedicate this program to a good friend of mine by the name of Rome Williams in Dayton, Ohio. I trust him and his wonderful wife is listening in to the program this morning. You know, it's good to be a Christian, isn't it?
Yes.
Somebody asked this fellow one time, said, "Are you a Christian?" He said, "No, I thank God I'm a Baptist."
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. I don't know what he meant by that. But those of you that's heard me preach many times, if you heard me preach different times from this scripture, now, in the first place, Jesus went through the cities and the villages teaching and preaching. He put teaching first. People need to be taught the Word of God.
That's right, amen.
Because they don't know the Word. And if you don't know the Word, you're going to be deceived in these last days.
That's right.
Because many false prophets have come on the scene. And many people are being deceived. But if you know the Word, you're not going to be deceived.
Amen.
In the fourth chapter of Proverbs, at verse 20, I think I'll back up here a little bit. I'll back up to verse 20 here. "My son, attend unto my words. Incline thine ears unto my sayings. Let them not depart from thine heart, thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. For they are life unto all those that find them, and health to all their flesh." Did you notice what the Word of God said? The Word of God is health to all your flesh. It's a medicine. That's why God told here in the book of Proverbs to incline thine ears to my sayings, keep them before your eyes. Keep looking at the Word of God. You may not have the promise right now, but keep looking at it.
Sorry.
Keep looking at it. Don't give up. And then incline your ears to my sayings. Listen to the Word of God. The Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And how can you hear without a preacher? And how beautiful are the feet of those that preach glad tidings and bring joy to the world. And the thoughts upon my heart this morning is, if you had a hope only in this life, the Bible says we'd be of all men most miserable. I'm glad there's hope beyond the grave. I'm glad that I'm just not going to be here and gone tomorrow. But I have the Bible calls this a blessed hope.
Uh-huh.
Heaven is going to be a reality.
Amen.
It's going to be worth everything, every mile I've ever traveled, every drop of sweat I've ever sweated preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. Because the preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ is the power of God unto salvation. To preach the cross, the old rugged cross, that he suffered and died for your sins and my sins. My friends, a lot of people don't realize that we've all been born into sin. We've all have been bitten by the serpent.
Mm-hmm.
You remember in the days of old when Moses put up a serpent on the pole, and if anybody looked to it, they were bitten. And if they looked to it, they would be healed. Well, that's the very type of Jesus being lifted up on the cross, and if we'll look to him, you can have your sins forgiven. You can be healed, spiritually speaking.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Bible tells us the Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. I'm so thankful today that one time I heard the Word.
Yeah.
And as I said a while ago, faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. And it don't come by just having heard. It comes by hearing and hearing and hearing Word of God until it gets, get it in your eyes,
right.
Get it in your ears, get it in your heart, get it down in your spirit.
Right.
And after a while, it'll become a reality because the Word of God is the final authority to this whole world's problem.
Amen.
The Word. If people would turn their life over to Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, and make him Lord of their life, there wouldn't be no killing going on. There wouldn't be no murdering. Wouldn't be no suffering little children. Everybody would have joy unspeakable and full of glory. Because the Bible tells us to be a Christian is a happy Christian. Thank God that you don't have to go around, and the Bible said, but he'll make us the head, not the tail. We don't have to go dragging around. He said, I'll put you above and not beneath. I'll bless your basket. That means your storehouse. I'll bless your children, the fruit of your body. He said, I'll bless you coming in, blessing going out, blesses when you lie down, and blesses you when you get up. So the Word of God is so powerful. And if we'll receive the engrafted Word of God, the Bible says that it's able to save your soul. But you've got to receive the Word. You've got to believe the Word. You've got to act upon the Word of God. Because faith is a fact and faith is an act. If you act, if you say you've got faith and don't act on the Word of God, then your works is dead.
Amen.
But thank God, if we act upon the Word of God, then it becomes alive to us. It's a lively stone. The Bible says we are a lively stone building up on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, and Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. And we're a live church today. The Bible says he has quickened us. That word quickened us means made alive. I was dead in my sins and my trespasses at one time. And then I looked at Jesus, I looked up, and he looked down, and I became a brand new creation in the Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. Old things, Sister Carter, had passed away. Yeah. Behold, all things become new. And I've been saved for 50-some years now, and I don't regret a mile. I don't regret a drop of sweat that I've ever sweat to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is a power of God unto salvation, and we're kept by the word of his power, the word of his power. And Jesus knew what the Word was when he was the Word. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Bible says the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten Son of God, full of grace, full of truth. He was the living Word of God. And I'm reading the written word right here, but it's alive. It's just as though Jesus was speaking to me right now. When I read the scripture, it's a written word, but he's a living word. And today he sits on the right hand of God, the Heavenly Father, making intercessions for the saints of God according to the will of God. So I'm thankful today that we have the word. We don't have to leave this world without Jesus. You don't have to leave this church this morning without the Lord. Because he is the Savior of all mankind. There's only one salvation. There's all kinds of religion in the world today. But I thank God I don't have religion. I have salvation. Salvation is of the Lord. How many know salvation is of the Lord?
Amen.
It's not of man.
Right.
It's the written word of God that has been given to us to serve God and to live for him. And to know that when we die, now friends, you're going to die, whether you know it or not. You're going to die. Everybody in this building is going to die one day. If Jesus tarries, thank God if he doesn't, then we're going in the rapture. We believe that he's coming after his church that's made herself ready, that's got on the wedding garment. We believe there's going to be a rapture, and the next great event on God's agenda, on God's calendar, is going to be the rapture of the church. We're going to be called out of this world. The Bible says Jesus is coming with a shout, the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ is going to rise first.
Right.
We which are alive and remain going to be changed in a moment, and a twinkling of an eye. Have you ever thought about getting a glorified body? Have you ever thought about trading this old body off and getting a new body? Getting a glorified body where there's no sickness, no disease, no pain, no devil, no nothing can touch it, because it's going to be a glorified body. That's why Jesus told Mary Magdalene when he rose from the dead, he said, touch me not. Because I've not ascended my God and your God and my Lord and your Lord. And when he did, he was glorified. His body was, he had a glorified body. And he left this world. Now he came into the world as a man like you and I. He was born in this world. Because that was the only way, the only remedy that would get mankind back to God. And so Jesus paid the supreme sacrifice for the sins of the world. I think so many times, Brother Child, when he went into the Garden of Gethsemane, he prayed until the sweat became as great drops of blood. He prayed, Father, let this cup pass from me, but not my will, thy will be done. He came back and he found the disciples asleep. And the last time they were asleep, he said, sleep on. He's going to say a lot to a lot of people that will not listen to the word of God, that will not give their life to God, he's going to say, sleep on. Uh-huh. They're going to be like the five foolish virgins. Five was wise, five was foolish. The five wise taken oil in their vessel and went out to meet the bridegroom. The five foolish went out. They were virgins too. That represents something clean. But they didn't have no oil in their vessel. They didn't have the Spirit of God. I believe that represents the Spirit of God. And when the call was made, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go you out to meet him. They all rose to trim their lamps. And the foolish said, that didn't have no oil, said to the wise, give us of your oil, because our light has gone out. That showed they had a light at one time.
Amen.
That showed they had backslid on God. They had lost out on God. And the Bible says that while they went to buy, they said, not so, lest we got enough oil for ourselves. But go rather to those who sell and buy. And while they went, the door was shut. Well, here come the five foolish a little later on, knocking on the door. And he said, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I know you not. You know what happened to them? They went to hell. Yes, there was a hell to gain, and a hell to go, and a heaven to gain. So we know the rich man, when he lifted up his eyes in hell, being tormented in the flame, let no preacher tell you that hell is not going to be real. It's going to be a real reality. As sure as that, this preacher is standing in this pulpit this morning. Hell is going to be real because the rich man lifted up his eyes. You remember Lazarus sat at the gate of the rich man begging for crumbs.
Amen.
Had nothing to eat.
Amen.
Begging for the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. And he wouldn't give them to him. Not even the crumb. But you know what? The Bible says finally, Lazarus died and was carried by the angels of God to Abraham's bosom. Now, Abraham's bosom was the upper compartment of hell. It was a place called paradise. There is no paradise today. There is no purgatory. There is no place like that. It's either heaven or it's hell. And he was carried by the angel into Abraham's bosom. And then the rich man died. And the Bible says he lifted up his eyes, being tormented in the flame. And he began to pray. You know, there's some things in hell that need to be in the church. One of them is prayer. Uh-huh. And another thing, he had a burden. He wanted Father Abraham to send someone to his father's house and warn them not to come to this place of torment. Because he said, I'm being tormented in this flame. And so Abraham sent word back to him. There's a great gulf fixed between us, and you can't come to him, neither can he come to you. So he found out that he could not get out of hell. Don't let anybody tell you once you get there that some man's going to pray you out. You're going to pay. I never will forget. I had a lady came to my apartment one time many years ago, and she said, you know what? Said, I'll tell you what. Said, my husband got prayed out of hell. Said, we give him a lot of money, but he finally got him out. And I thought to myself, I'm a baby Christian. I know better than that. You don't pray nobody out of hell. But she thought that the more money they give, the quicker it got him out of hell. Well, that's false teaching. That's false doctrine. Don't you believe that doctrine? Because once you're there, you're there. And the Bible says there's coming the great white throne judgment day. The Word of God tells us there's coming the day that the books is going to be opened. There's 66 books in this Bible. And the dead is going to be raised. Death and hell is going to be raised. And they're going to be judged out of these books. And if their names is not found written in the Lamb's Book of Life, they will be cast into the lake of fire, which is the second death. Blessed and holy is he that has part in the first resurrection. For the second death has no power. Thank God we don't have to go to hell. Thank God Jesus paid it all. He paid for your sins. He paid for your death penalty. He paid for all mankind's suffering that we suffered in this world. And he paid for it all with his precious blood.
Sure,
but you know, the day is going to come that we're going to hear his voice.
Yep.
Come on up here. The day is going to come that the trumpet's going to sound. The day is going to come that the graves are going to burst open. Glory to God. Somebody wrote this old song, ain't no grave going to hold my body down. When that trumpet sounds, I'm coming up out of the ground, for there ain't no grave gonna hold my body down.
Amen.
Well, I looked over yonder, and what do you think I seen? I seen a band of angels coming after me, cause there ain't no grave gonna hold this body down. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. When that trumpet sound, Lord's coming up out of that ground, cause there ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Thank God for that song. Little did that know, that brother know, that that song would go worldwide. And it did, and thank God for it. So we know that the Word of God is the only remedy in this world that's going to save America. It's going to save the world if you listen to it. Jesus has no respecter of person.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what color your skin is. It's not a skin problem. It's a sin problem.
Amen.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who you are, where you're at in the world today, what nation, what city that you're in. God loves you. A lot of people couldn't tell you what John 3:16 says. God so loved this world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Did you ever think about just living forever?
Amen.
Without any sickness, without any pain, without any financial difficulties, without any government, without anybody telling you what to do and when to do and how to do it? Did you ever think about living like that? Thank God the day is going to come that we're going to heaven. I said a while ago, it's going to be a beautiful place. The gates of pearls, the walls of jasper, the streets of gold. I've not had much gold down here to walk on. In fact, I ain't had any. But the day's going to come, we're going to walk on the streets of gold, Sister Carter.
Amen.
The day is going to come that we're going to see Jesus for him as our Lord and Savior. As Don sung that song ago, I want to bow at the feet of Jesus. When I get to heaven, the first thing I want to do is bow at his feet. And I know I've got loved ones that's gone on to be with the Lord. I'm looking forward to seeing them again. See, that's a blessed hope that the church has.
Amen.
We have the greatest salvation of the world. There's no other salvation. Buddha's not the way. Muhammad's not the way. Harry Christian's not the way. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes.
No man comes to the Father except through and by him. And he's a reality, friend.
Amen.
He's a personal Savior. And when you get acquainted with him, your life changes. My life changed from a drunkard to from a gambler. My life was changed because I give my heart to the Lord. Many years ago, on an old-fashioned altar, I tell this quite often, I went to church that night, me and my buddy and his wife and my wife, and somehow they got us up on the front pew. And that night I went to the altar when the preacher preached. He preached on the blood of Jesus Christ. And I knew I was a sinner. I knew that I was lost. You see, you'll never get saved until you get lost. And I knew I was a sinner. And I knew I had to get born again. Born from above. Born by the Spirit of God.
Amen.
And I didn't join no religion. I didn't sign no church card. I didn't shake the preacher's hand. I cried my way that night. I wept my way in repentance because I was a sinner and I was a bad sinner and I mistreated my family. But thank God that night something got a hold of me.
Yeah.
I went there that night, as that old song says, but something got a hold of me and changed my life and made a new creature out of me. And the Word of God says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Everything becomes new. Even the grass looks greener. Even the sky looks bluer. Even the birds sing beautiful. Amen. Because you are a Christian. You have been born from above. And you got the nature of God. Isn't it wonderful to have the nature of God? What is the nature of God? You love everybody. You love everybody. Now, I don't love a lot of people's ways, but I love everybody. I want to help everybody if I can. And you know what? A lot of preachers today, they may be preaching for the money and for the salary they're getting. But if I was preaching for the money, I'd quit a long time ago, friend. Thank God for this salvation. It's freely given to us. The Bible says, freely you have received, freely you give.
Amen.
Freely you give. I want to give. I want to give you something.
Amen.
I don't want to take nothing from you. I want to give you something. I want to tell you that Jesus can be Lord of your life and change your nature.
Amen.
Change your nature. As I said, we got the nature of God. We have the Spirit. And in fact, we're in the God class. I didn't say we were God now. But we do have the Spirit And as God has, if the Spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the same Spirit that's going to quicken your mortal body, that means make you alive.
Uh-huh.
We're alive. We're a premortal agent today to serve God. Nobody can stop you. There ain't enough demon powers of hell can stop you. There's not enough devil, not enough devils and fallen angels can stop you.
Come on.
If you've got a ready made up mind for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Amen.
I wish this morning, my prayer is that those of you that are in sin, those of you, you say, well, Brother Burgess, I'm a pretty good moral man. I take care of my wife, my family. I support them, and I do all that. But you're lost.
Amen.
You're lost. I don't care how good you think you are. Your goodness is not going to get you saved.
Right.
It's going to take the blood. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission for sin. It takes the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son. And if you give your life to Him, the blood will cleanse you. The blood will make you whole. Thank God it'll sanctify you. What does that word sanctification mean? It means set apart from this world. Now, we're in the world, but we're not of the world because He has chosen us out of the world. Do you realize this morning that we are adopted sons and daughters?
Amen.
We are adopted into the family of God. Thank God. Through the love of Jesus Christ. When nobody was found worthy in heaven or in, and he looked in heaven, looked in the earth, and looked beneath the earth and found nobody worthy, Jesus said, I'll go. I'll pay the supreme sacrifice. And he came into this world as a child, born in the manger. He wanted to grow up like we grow up. He wanted to know what sin was. He wanted to know what persecution was. He wanted to know all these things. And he did. And the Bible says he was the only perfect Lamb of God that ever walked this earth.
Mm-hmm.
He kept the law to the letter. He kept everything that God gave him to keep. And he went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. You know, we got a lot of people oppressed today. We got a lot of people today that's sick. He can be your healer. He can deliver you from sickness and disease. I know, I've been healed. Praise God. I know the doctor wanted to take my stomach out many years ago. Well, you can very well see that I still got my stomach, amen? Because I give my life to the Lord and the life that I live, and God cleaned me up and saved me and sanctified me and set me apart and made me a citizen of heaven. I'm so glad today that I'm a citizen of heaven.
Amen.
My destiny is set on heaven. I don't know where yours is at. You may say, well, I don't have no hope. I don't have nowhere to go. Yes, you do. You may be in a convalescent home. You may be in a hospital. You may be in a morgue. I mean, you may be headed for the morgue. I don't know, but a lot of your loved ones are with you. But the thing of it is, you don't leave this world without knowing Jesus Christ. And if you do, and you're lost, hell's going to be your destiny. God help you this morning. I want to pray a prayer. I would like for everyone that's listening to me to bow their heads in prayer and repeat the sinner's prayer after me. If you're really sincere in your heart and you really want God, now the Bible says we'll lay hands on them, they shall recover. I can't reach you. I can't lay my hands on you. But I can lead you in prayer. I can tell you how to be born again. I can tell you how to find Jesus, or Jesus find you. He didn't find, I didn't find him, he found me. And if you'll pray the sinner's prayer with me, repeat the words after me, or if you're sick in body and you need a divine healing, we have prayer cloths, and Brother Don's going to come up and tell you about the prayer cloths that we give out. Over 300 of them everywhere. People everywhere are asking for them. Even sinners are asking for them. And we're going to pray over them, anoint them with oil, and we'll send them to you. Just call, and Don will give you that information in a few moments. But right now, I want that congregation to bow your head with me as we pray for the whole world that's listening in, every nation that's listening. Heavenly Father, repeat this prayer after me. Say, Heavenly Father, dear God in heaven, I'm a sinner. I need to be saved. I want this hope that this preacher's talking about. I want this blessed hope. I want to know you in the power of your resurrection. I want to know you as Lord and Savior and Master. I want to be acquainted with you. I want to be your son or your daughter. Will you come into my life right now? Forgive me of all my sins. I cannot forgive myself. I cannot get good enough to be saved. It's going to take your blood to cleanse me. Dear God in heaven, write my name in the book of life. Forgive me. And then, Lord, I'm sick in body. You said in your word, whatsoever things that we desire, when we pray, believe that we receive them and we shall have them. That means even our sickness, we can be healed. We can have miracles happen. I've seen miracles in my ministry, and I'm asking God right now to give you a miracle. Will you give your life to the Lord right now in the name of Jesus and say, here I am, Lord, and all I ever hoped to be, I'm giving to you on the altar this morning. Wherever you're at, in a motel, convalescent home, hospital, wherever you're at, just give your heart to the Lord in Jesus' name, and then write and let us know. I humbly ask and pray in his precious and lovely name, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen, amen.
Brother
Don, come and give some information to the people.
Thank you, Pastor. It's a good message this morning.
Amen.
There's three ways that you can contact us here. First way is you can write us a note, send it to us in the mail. That's our address is Trenton Church of God, 35 Roerich. That's R-O-E-H-R-I-G. Trenton, Michigan. Our zip code is 48183. Again, that's 35 Roerich, R-O-E-H-R-I-G, Trenton, Michigan, 48183. We have an email. We've been getting some through our email. That's TrentonChurchOfGod@att.net. All small letters, all one word. We're also on the web. Our web address is TrentonChurchOfGod.com. There you can find that there's a place that you can leave us a message. Tell us what your need is, what your praise report is, or just tell us what your prayer request is. We're starting to get some coming in. We've had two prayer requests last weekend. We took care of both of those. If you can view past sermons on our website. You can even see upcoming events. Next month, the ladies' ministry is putting on a bean dinner, I believe, or you can come and have fellowship with us. There's going to be some good old-fashioned cornbread. That sounds pretty good to me. But visit us on the web. You can see the time. And it's a small donation for this. This will help the church through the upcoming months of winter. So just come be a part of us. If you'd like to visit us and be a part of our service, we'd love to have you. If you're looking for a home church, come visit us. Help us to grow. Come in. Our church times are 10:30 in the morning on Sunday, 6 o'clock on Sunday evening, Wednesday at 7 o'clock. Good word, good singing, good fellowship. We also got that ministry. We have a powerful, powerful prayer cloth ministry, like the pastor was telling you. So, each time you contact us, you have a need, your praise report, somebody got healed in your family, someone, one of your friends that you prayed for got healed, let us know. We'll share it. We'll share it with the world if that's what you want. But you have to start by letting us know. Thank you very much.